Ghazala Shaikh. I'm a Unani herbalist, and today I'm here to give you a talk on herbs versus pharmaceutical medicine. It's not called Unani herbs because you cannot label herbs with any one system of medicine. They are just universal. So before starting the talk, I would first like to share with you why I chose this topic, herbs versus pharmaceutical drugs. Last month I was in Delhi. I was enjoying the winter of Delhi, and I met my friend who is a very good cardiologist practicing in a big hospital there. So during our conversation, we had a little debate on this topic, where he was very confident of his evidence-based, modern, quick, fast testing, life-saving drug molecules and treatment modalities, and I was just silent. Because I also believe in scientific skepticism. I didn't want to advocate and profess herbal medicine just because I belong to the system or it's what I believe or I have been taught for the last 5 or 6 years in my college days. So I came back and I did a SWOT analysis of both the systems, and my talk is, the objective of my talk is to share with you some of the interesting facts and statistics, and ultimately the truth which I realized going through the subject and what I'm presenting before you through this talk. And I hope that at the end you will able to understand, and that will help you to take an informed decision when you are looking for the alternative mode for healing or cure or relief for your health problem. So here we go. Ask anyone today, like my learned friend or the cardiologist, or there are many strong believers of the Western system of medicine, what they think about herbal medicine. So you will come across that, you will come with the replies like it is unscientific, unproved, primitive, ineffective, possibly dangerous, and does not have a place in modern age. So out of all these six allegations, I admit that herbal medicine is really a primitive form of treatment. But what would you say if I'll tell you that 120 active compounds which are currently used by the modern medical science are derived from the plant kingdom? More than 75% of hormones used in modern medicine are from plants. And interestingly, 80% show a positive correlation between their modern therapeutic use and the traditional use. And last not the least, according to WHO, 80% of the world population still depends upon the plant kingdom, the herb, for their primary health needs. Now these are some of the examples. Like everyone today is aware of the drug digitalis, which is a cardiac stimulant. The source is a plant called foxglove. Then we have anti-clotting agent humerol, which is derived from sweet clover. A very famous and popular tranquilizer, which is reserpine. It's used to lower the blood pressure these days, is derived from the plant called snake root. Similarly, everybody is aware of quinine, which is an anti-malarial and derived from the cinchona bark. And finally, aspirin, the blood thinner from the willow bark. So, as I told you, I will start my arguments on this subject through the SWOT analysis. So, first we will start about the strength of the system, the herbal medicine. The basic strength of herbal medicine is that it works with nature, not against it. So now what is this nature and how the nature is related with the plant kingdom? Friends, nature, mother nature is ever green, ever beautiful and ever vibrant with life. And the source and plants are the source and origin of life on this planet. As you all aware of that, the chlorophyll that present in the leaves of the plant, they capture the solar energy and convert it into the useful nutrients. So let's start with the how the herbs work with the nature. As we all know that whatever metabolism is going inside our body, whether it's an animal body or it's a plant body, it is a slow process of oxidation. In which we excreted out carbon dioxide. And this carbon dioxide is taken by the plant for their structural repairs, and they breath it out oxygen. Oxygen, which is the very breath of life. So from here we can realize that herbs are actually the source and origin and the sustainer of life on this planet. Move to the second slide, or the second strength is that the herbs have the biological intelligence of life force inherent in them. Now, what is this life force? The life force is vitality. Like the people said that plant kingdom or the herbal medicine is unscientific. It's totally wrong. It can be proven. It is scientific because the plant has evolved the ability over these years. The plant also synthesized some chemical some chemical compounds which are called secondary metabolites. Even the plants have their own defensive system. Even the plants are faced with various kind of predators. Just they have to resist themselves for the insects, for the fungus growth, for various bacteria, for pollutants. So what these herbs do for maintaining their defense, for resisting these kind of predators, they synthesize some chemical compounds which are called as secondary metabolites, which kills the predators. But at the same time, these secondary metabolites, which are mostly aromatic and phenols, these chemical constituents are useful when beneficial to the human being when they are used for treatment of the disease. So the intelligence of the biological intelligence of the herb is utilized by the mankind. It is said in the Bible is, let the fruit thereof for the meat and the leaves for the healing of the nation, which advocates the use of herbs as a first treatment modality for the mankind. Herbs are gentle, safer, and have far fewer negative side effects. Now, gentle doesn't mean that they are totally safe or they are ineffective. Gentle means that these herbs are so mild in their action that they can be taken for longer periods of time without any question of safety. This involves cumin, mint, thyme, these kind of herbs which are very mild in their action, they are gentle. But please don't misunderstand that there are no toxic plants. There are some plants who are poisonous, who are toxic, and if they are used without the proper guidance and precautions, they can lead to very severe reactions. Like we heard in the hospital, one lady, she took some plants which she believed to be a kind of medicine. So she watched some program on the TV and she thought that the herb which is growing in that her garden is same. So she took the preparation, she prepared the preparation and had it herself and ended herself in the ICU. So please don't misunderstand that herbs have no side effect or they are totally safe. The you have to understand that if something is having effects, it's definitely going to have side effects also. Herbs have the nutritive value that the synthetic drugs lack because herbs are organic. They assimilate the mineral in organic matter from the soil and the solar energy through the sun rays, and it's converted into the living organic material, which is when presented to the body is hungrily absorb that nutrition, and it uses that material to relieve and restore and sustain its life energy. And herbs are nothing but they are nutrient-full superfoods which help the body to sustain their life force. The wheel of nature grinds slowly, but they work very well. One of the functions of herbs is that they consist of a number of molecules, chemical molecules. They are having the nutritive properties, and they are able to satisfy the deficiencies of the cell. The tissue or the cell who are lacking in several minerals and trace materials, when herbs are used, these deficiencies get fulfilled, and as a result, it takes a gradual time period to reach the level to get the desired therapeutic effect. That's why herbs need to be taken longer, because they assimilate in the body system, they correct the deficiency, and then only you can get the therapeutic result of a herb. And last but not the least, in herbs we believe a philosophy that is called herbal synergism. From this and go back to the drug. What is drug? Drug is a Dutch word which is derived, it's a Dutch word from, there is a Dutch word called droog, from which the word drug is derived. Droog means nothing but dried plant. So when the source is same, why we are, we have so different approaches.